Chapter 5, Sneaking Away Before Lord Knows. Pug was running to the woods away from the manor. Dawn was breaking. He didn't want to get caught in the morning, nor would Tom, because he was never forced back to France. If you ask me, Tom, I reckon that I'm supposed to be remade in Australia instead of England. Too right, Pug. I think the police don't know our case, which means they're about to realize that you're a mystery train, and the world hasn't known me for years, except Australia. But suddenly, to their horror, they saw a policeman who seemed to block their way. It has come to my knowing, he said, that you, Pug, have been remade without permission asked to the scrapyard manager from someone that seems to have no record. Of course I did, sir, and it's none of your business about me that is involved of what has happened in Kent Manor. You might deal with it. He'll get stressed if he don't watch out, the policeman snorted. Besides, I think it looks like he's had enough of this affair, and that's no excuse he's making. Pug came to the woods. The sun was beginning to come up. I hope we don't get detected. In through the woods he went, and onto a quiet common on the safe journey to Tasman's show door. Rain was starting to fall. Pug ran like a cannon bomb about to blow up. Of course, he knew that he had to make sure if nobody stalks him. And what they don't know, the UK police has said he was remade so he can reunite with Gingy. It was very hard to hide and not get seen by any wrong anybody. He hoped the talks won't get him on the run. His life would come to an end. The journey was very long, but he didn't care. All he just wanted was to find a new home. He ran for over an hour until 10 a.m. came. This is where I can rest and wait for Gingy. Percy and Gingy are silent. Do you think the UK will leave you alone? Asked Percy. I hope so, because I like to work with my buddy Gingy. By then, Percy, we'll be doing some work here. Bye then, you two. I'll just find Thomas in Tuller. Percy was glad his friends were reunited.